thinking about bringing the foot just up and over the ankle, but very quickly to train the foot and the stiffness in the ankle. Remember to make circles, not just up and down. Calf dribble, I'm pulling the foot just up and over the calf. Okay, that refers to height. Again, it's not a full way up to hip height. I'm coming just over the calf and back down. Remember to dorsiflex the ankle real well. I'm going to grab foot behind and pull up quickly. So we're getting quad pull and then knee to chest. When I get that knee pulling into chest, stay tall through my torso and extend this leg. Fire glute, extend the knee. Reaching RDL, I reach the hand as far away from the rear foot as I can. So I'm reaching with same side hand and foot and bending slightly on the stance leg. Reverse power lunge, I drop down and drive up in a very reactive manner. So I'm not down, pause, and then up. I'm down, explode up. Again, be long on that stance leg. Extend that knee. Standing arm action, you're going to lean into the front leg. Same arm action you would use in acceleration or sprint. Okay, here, I'm going to start rotating at the shoulder, but we like to do that on signal. So using the numbers works well. I'm going to go up to six and back to one. One, one, two, one, two, three. Up to the number six, back down to the number one. Be very reactive there, okay? Every movement is as fast as you can go. Try to avoid rotation through your torso. Spider-Man is great for just general hip mobility. You're going to go into a high plank position. I'm going to bring that foot up next to the hand. Make sure my rear leg is extended. Make it straight. From there, I'm going to reach same side arm up. Foot comes back. Other foot comes up without going up and down at my hips. Scissor jump is a reactive means of alternating foot position. So I drop down and switch feet. It's basically a reactive lunge, but I'm getting tall and pushing the ground away as I get up. Keep my torso in the same position the whole time. So the first march variation is in a prisoner hand position, and you're going to be doing it with a pause. So you're going to bring the knee up, pause, back down, up, up. Bring it up quickly, and make sure that when you come up, that you extend on this leg and fire the glute. While you're holding at the top, you're holding a really strong glute contraction. Second march variation, you're going to incorporate your arms. So you're getting tall, tall. Drive that knee up and through. Think about getting knee to chin. But again, when you do that, you're getting long on the stance leg, okay? And make sure that you're engaging that glute as you come up. As always, make sure to dorsiflex on that lead leg coming up, up, up. But it does become cyclical. Third march variation, reaching overhead, up, 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 up. I'm incorporating the entire kinetic chain and reaching from the ground and the toe of that stance leg all the way up through the same side arm. So you're teaching that good connection and drive all the way through the column. So wall drills, we have three of them. First one. This is about power. This is about getting onto the front of the foot and exploding up, think coming out of blocks or starting. So I reach back. My front leg is out in front of me here, and I put the knee over the toe, not behind it. It's got to be over it. I've got a straight line now down from my ear to the back leg. From here, I explode forward and up. Onto this toe, I extend that leg, fire the glute, and bring this leg up in front in a dorsiflex position. Again, reverse piston. So this is about being really reactive at the hip, primarily the hip flexors. It's also about maintaining a strong torso without flexion during that motion. I lean into the wall with my feet parallel or together. Fire your glutes. From here, I'm going to drive up and back down very quickly. It's up and down quickly without hunching through your middle. Alternating piston, same movement, okay? But now we're going to get that kind of reactivity between right and left as I alternate positions. Okay, I'm here with one knee up, same lean, but one knee is up. I go one, two, three. Opposite leg is now up. Again, dorsiflex position. This leg is extended. Be reflexive here. Ankling. Okay, so this is about making the foot and the ankle stiffer in relation to, you know, running, especially on the track. Okay, if you're sloppy at the ankles, we don't transfer force and energy well. So I'm tall with hands on hips, and I'm hitting the floor with the front of the foot. What you don't want to see is this here or bending the knees. It's just at the ankle and foot. Okay, power skip. Now, if you're limited on distance, just get 2 to 3 reps and then start and come back. Again, you're thinking about pushing into the floor, all right, and driving out of the forefoot. Have strong upper body mechanics. Keep that knee up high as you finish the movement and don't allow it to sag down too quickly. Slider acceleration. So for those limited on space, here we do our acceleration in a prone position. Toes on sliders. Okay, I'm gonna get up in a strong position through my shoulders and my middle. I bring one leg forward. 10 reps. Rest. Okay, maybe 10 seconds. Reset with the opposite leg forward. Reset. You'll go 4 sets there. Make sure that your middle isn't moving all over the place and that you're long and stable through your elbow.